Isang magandang umaga muli, mga kapatid ko sa Panginoon. Papuri at pasasalamat ang ating ibigay sa ating Diyos sa panibagong araw muli. At dahil may pagkakataon na naman tayo na mag-aral ng kanyang salita. Ang title ng ating devotion ay The Certainty of God's Promise. At ang ating passage ay makikita sa Hebrews chapter 6, verse 13 to 18. And it says, "For when God made a promise to Abraham, since he had no one greater by whom to swear, he swore by himself, saying, 'Surely I will bless you and multiply you.' And thus Abraham, having patiently waited, obtained the promise. For people swear by something greater than themselves, and in all their disputes an oath is final for confirmation. So when God desired to show more convincingly to the heirs of the promise the unchangeable character of his purpose, he guaranteed it with an oath, so that by two unchangeable things in which it is impossible for God to lie, we who have fled to refuge might have strong encouragement to hold fast to the hope set before." Let us pray first. Oh dear God, thank you again sa araw na ito. Pagpalaan niyo po ang aming devotion. Pagpalaan niyo po ang bawat isa na nakakikinig. Nawa kayong patuloy na pumatnubay sa kanila. Itong masamad dalangin sa pangalan ni Jesus. Amen. Isa po sa mga paboritong hymn ng ating mga kabataan doon po sa Junior Church is yung kantang Standing on the Promises of God. At kung memorize niyo po ito, ang second verse, ito po ang sinasabi, "Standing on the promises that cannot fall." And yung fourth verse naman, ito po ang sinasabi, "Standing on the promises I cannot fall." Itong pong mga linya na kantang ito, or these verses, declare a simple truth. When standing on the promises of God, we cannot fall because the promises of God cannot fail. Kung titingnan po natin yung meaning ng promise, a promise is the announcement of an intention, an announcement of something to be done. We all have made promises to people. Tama po ba yun? Tama po yun. We have made promises to people and had promises made to us from others. Not because of any intentionality of failing to make good on these promises made. The truth is, tayo po bilang mga tao, we all have fallen short or failed to perform every promises or promise made. Kaya nga po ang tanong na kailangan sagutin ngayong umagang ito. So what makes the difference when it comes to promises made by God? Why is it that we can bank on or we can trust God to make good on His promise? Why is it that we can be sure of being able to stand on any promise God gives? And we will study two reasons for an answer, or I will offer two reasons for an answer. The first reason is we can stand on the promises because of the nature of God. It is because of the nature of God. The promises of God cannot fail because of the nature of God. It is the nature of God that makes His promises trustworthy, something sure to stand on. An attribute of God that He does not share with us human beings is what we call immutability. This attribute means that God is unchanging in His character, His will, and His promises. Yun po yung immutability. Therefore, tayo po bilang mga mananampalataya, we can have absolute confidence in God's reliability to make good on His promise, because of His unchanging character. Tandaan po natin ito, mga kaibigan, mga kapatid. It is the integrity of God's character that makes it possible for God, or makes it impossible for God to lie. Wala po sa kakayanan ng Panginoon na po siya ay magsinungaling. Kaya nga po, tandaan po natin, we can, without wavering or without any hesitation, hold tightly to God's word because He is faithful and reliable in keeping His promise. God will keep His promise. Sabi po sa Hebrews chapter 10 verse 23, let us hold fast the confession of our faith without wavering, for he who promised is faithful. Napaganda pong verse na yan. Numbers 23 verse 19, God is not a man that he should lie, nor a son of man that he should repent. Has he said, and will he not do? Or has he spoken, and will he not make it good? Ayun po yung mga salita ng Panginoon, that we can hold on to the promise of God because of His unchanging character, of the because of the nature of God. And the second reason is, we can stand on the promises because of the nature of God's word. The nature of God's word is based on the character of God. In other words, since God is faithful, wala siyang kakayanan mag-lie, His word also is reliable. And there are five special distinct qualities of God's word that guarantees that it cannot fail. Thereby, we can rely on it. Yung number one pong special distinct qualities of God's word is this. God's word is perfect. Sabi po yan sa Psalms 19 verse 7. The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul. The testimony of the Lord is sure, making wise the simple. And yung pangalawa po, na special distinct qualities of God's word is pure, proving true. Diyan po natin makikita yan sa Proverbs chapter 30, verse 5. Every word of God is pure. He is a shield to those who put their trust in Him. At yung pangatla po, God's word is permanent, being established and settled. Sabi po ng Psalms 119, verse 89, forever, O Lord, your word is settled in heaven. Napaganda po ng mga salita. Pang-apat po, God's word is perpetual, remaining forever. Ano po sabi ng Matthew chapter 24 verse 35? Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words, or the word of God, will by no means pass away. At yung panghuli po, yung panglima, God's word is powerful. Sabi po ng Hebrews chapter 11 verse 3, by faith, we understand that the worlds were framed by the word of God, so that the things which are seen were not made of things which are visible. Ganyan po, kapowerful ang salita ng Panginoon. He framed the world by His word. Kaya nga po tayo bilang mga mananampalataya, no matter how a situation looks in our life right now, brothers and sisters in the Lord, you and I can stand on the sure promises of God. At dito po tayo magtatapos. Sabi po dito, praise be to the Lord who has given rest to His people, Israel. Just as He promised, not word has failed of all the good promises He gave through. Tayo po saglit naman na lang hindi. Aming dakilang Diyos, maraming salamat muli sa inyong salita. Pagpalaan niyo po kami. Pagpalaan niyo pong lahat. Nawa, panghawakan po namin ang mga pangako niyo sa buhay ng bawat isa po sa amin. Salamat pong muli. Itong among samad dalangin sa pangalan ni Jesus. Amen. Magandang umaga muli. May God bless you all.